Hi everyone, and welcome to this video clip. This one's going to be really short. The only thing I'm going to demonstrate is creating a reverse lookup zone. You can see that I'm already connected into KW Server 1, which is my domain controller and also my DNS server. I also have the DNS manager open. Select reverse lookup zones. You'll notice that there are none, so we have to create one. Right click on the container. New zone launches the new zone wizard. I'm going to create a primary zone. I want it to be writable and also integrate into Active Directory so that the data is stored in the Active Directory database rather than a separate file. We're going to distribute this to all of the domain controllers in the dixon.local domain, which is exactly what I want. And this is going to be an IPv4 reverse lookup zone. We have to specify the network address. A couple ways of doing that. We can specify the network ID in forward mode up at the top here, or we can put it in reverse down at the bottom, which will match the actual name of the zone. It's a lot easier to put it in up at the top. I know my network is 192.168.70, so I'll put that information in. Notice down at the bottom that it generates the zone name by default, 70.168.192, so it reverses the order of the octets representing the network, and then .in-adder.arpa on the end. So I said before, you have to make sure that this name is exactly correct, otherwise reverse lookup will not work. So let's say next. We will allow dynamic updates, that's fine. Everything we're doing is server 2012, so they can all be secure. And we'll say next, and then finish, and we're basically done. So in the reverse lookup zones, if I expand that container out, I can see the zone that I just created. If I select that, I have my start of authority record, and I have my name server record. And that's it. The zone is complete. You can populate it as you wish. That's the end of this video. Hope it was helpful, and we'll see you next time.